Hi, welcome again to another bench evaluation. I'm Ken Brooks. Today we're going to be going over the Smith & Wesson SW22 Victory. This is their new little 22 semi-auto. Before we get started, I'm going to show you that it is indeed empty. We have one dummy round. Me and the cameraman have checked everything out, and made sure that there's no live ammo floating around, so everybody's safe. So on to the gun. It's a stainless steel. I don't have any idea what the price is on these. Doesn't really matter, we're just doing a bench evaluation. There are some things I like and some things I don't like. The gun feels good in my hand. Granted, that's a personal preference, and I always try to tell people, you know, if I don't like something, but not based on a mechanical defect, but on a personal preference. So the gun feels good in my hands. May not in yours. You might have bigger hands or smaller hands. For me, it feels okay. It's fairly heavy. I think it's going to shoot well, partially because of the weight. It's not a detractor, it's just it's a fairly heavy gun. I did take it apart, field stripped, to check it out. The trigger pull is fairly creepy, but light. The relationship between the sear and the hammer is positive. As you pull the trigger, the hammer's cammed back. That's a good thing. As it wears, it's going to remain positive for quite a while before it wears to negative, neutral, then negative, to where it would be unsafe. So that's good. And it's light. Most positive trigger pulls are heavy. The slide stop engages the slide, and it is positive as well. As you go to pull the slide stop down, it cams the slide back ever so slightly, and that's good. When they're negative, the slide comes back. As it slams forward, if it's negative, it can force the slide stop out of engagement and close when you don't want it to close. So that's a good thing. It's a little tight, but I can manipulate it with my thumb, so it's not overly tight. Tight, difficult to disengage. The extractor is pretty good. The hook is a little further from the breech face than what we like. It's probably going to work just fine. It is positive to where it's sharp. It wants to dig into the rim of the case. And it doesn't quite have as much tension as we would like. So the hook moves over and hits. If this is our cartridge, the extractor should hit and push the cartridge case over to the opposite side of the breech face so it holds on. It's close, but it doesn't have as much tension as I would like. On a thinner case, on a bigger case, obviously it wouldn't be a problem. On a thinner case, you could run into some feeding issues. Now, I believe the boys down in Nevada have test fired this and whatnot at the range, so that'll be the range section of this, which you'll see, and they'll obviously know whether or not it jams and how accurate it shoots. It's got some neat features, such as a removable rear sight, and you simply put on a scope rail. And it comes with a fixed sight on the back of it as well. Kind of neat. It has, for me, the kiss of death, magazine disconnect. With the magazine out, the gun won't fire. It's not a defense gun. It's just a toy. It's a fun gun, competition, plinking, having a little fun. But I'm not a fan of magazine disconnects. When that magazine's out, I still want the gun to be able to fire. The takedown is supposed to be super simple. One of the selling features on this was promoted as it's so much simpler to take apart than everyone knows the Rugers. Of course, Rugers come out with their new one, but regardless. That's true, except that you must have an Allen wrench to unscrew the screw right here. Smith & Wesson does supply the Allen wrench to take down the gun. So once that screw is out, up, forward, and off. You can see the bottom here real quick. Again, hammer won't fall because we don't have the magazine in. The magazine is steel. It appears to be a fairly well-made magazine. Pretty simple. A lot of the 22 magazines are all basically the same. This one appears okay. Goes in, and then we can check our trigger pull. Now don't push down on your trigger bar here, because that's your disconnector. So it needs to be up, and hopefully the camera will be able to show that and my thumb is here just simply so the hammer won't fall. But as I pull that, we're a bit creepy. I don't know if you can see that or not. It's ever so slightly positive. There we go. You can kind of see it. And it's ever so slightly, but it is positive. That's a good thing. Got a buffer here, which is pinned in place, which means it's removable, which is going to be nice. It also means it's not going to fall out when you field strip your gun. There are some guns on the market that when you take them apart, the buffer just falls out. Dang it. Gets lost. Buffers do wear because they stop the pounding of the slide. So the fact it's replaceable is a very good thing. There are some other guns on the market where the buffer's considered a semi-permanent installation. When they deteriorate and fall out, it can be a pain in the neck to put in, reinstall a new one. Take the magazine out, just so I can point out right here is the slide stop where it engages on the slide. And I mentioned, turn it this way so you can see it, that we were positive, and we are. I'm going to lay that off to the side. It's cast steel. I've got plastic grips, but I think the gun's going to work out pretty well. The top half, the bolt comes right out the back. Pretty dang simple. Which one should I do first? We'll lay that off the side. If you take the Allen wrench and take out this, well, I'll just do it. We'll just take out this screw. Fairly snug. You could hear it. The barrel comes right out the upper. What's nice about that is you can get a whole bunch of different barrels. Longer barrels, shorter barrels, thinner barrels, barrels that are threaded for attachments. The list goes on and on and on. And it's simply held in place by that little divot where the screw goes in. What's nice also is you're going to be able to pull that out to polish the chamber as need, fit your extractor slot as need. So slide that back in place and screw it back down in. Now the receiver, the upper receiver assembly, this piece is stamped sheet metal. Not a problem. It's just basically a guide for the bolt. All well and good. The breech bolt. Here's your recoil spring and guide, and you come up from the back, and we'll go into more detail on this when we do the DNR on it, but comes right out the bottom. And what's nice is they put a divot in here, so when you go to reassemble it, there we go. So I push it forward and up, comes into place right here. And of course, when you're on camera, everything goes bad. I'm sure you guys know. Now, the extractor, I mentioned that we don't quite have as much tension as we'd like. It snaps up here. We're a little loose, but it won't quite fall off. But it does slide down off the breech face, so the tension needs to be increased. The hook is positive. The extractor plunger is kind of unique. We have this little leg that sticks out here, and that leg positions our plunger in this groove. It also gives you something to grasp to pull back so we can rotate our extractor out of there. I'm going to let that plunger come out now. Extractor, conventional 22 type extractor. And there's our spring and plunger. So extractor plunger is kind of cool. All in all, the gun, I believe, is going to be a seller. I believe it's going to work and be fine. I don't like the magazine disconnect. I prefer guns that don't have those. But everything that's here is either correct or can easily be made correct. The hammer shear relationship's positive. The extractor's fairly good, needs some minor tweaks here and there. The slide stop is correct. I don't foresee there being a problem with the gun feeding. Maybe a little bit of extraction ejection. We'll let the boys decide. We'll see you next time.